shepherd bishop,
and I see you.
The shepherd bishop,
empowering you,
and motivating you
to be one flock under one shepherd.
The shepherd bishop, enlightening you,
empowering you,
and motivating you to be one flock under one shepherd.
And if you read that little book,
realize really that it was a lot. It was a very difficult journey. A journey that showed how passionate and resolved it was to make it to the priesthood. Everything possible was against him. His education, when he wanted to go to the secondary school, was a problem. And yet, God sent a helper. He tells the story because that time there were many secondary schools around. You had one in Abuja, one in Abuja, one in Enugu, and then after some time, the Theresa Sika and Nsukka. His first attempt was about he passed the exam, waiting that the governor general will be reason to have to be. He was considered too big to be in the secondary school. He didn't give up. By then, the president had been started, and he came and joined the president, the second step ever to study at the president's college. And that was where, after attending the first ordination ever here at St. Teresa's Cathedral Church of Monsignor Reverend, he decided to be a priest. And his classmates, even the principal of SDC, thought he was a big joke. Prof is not here, but Prof cannot be a bishop. His classmate, Professor Julius Onah, is quoted as saying, "See, there's an Ichie Father, Ichie Bishop." If you become a priest, now become a bishop. That is a priest. But I don't know from what theological interpretation we can get that from is a bishop. And his principal told him, "See, there's that. You can't be a priest without always fighting." And not only that he became a priest, he became a priest within very strange and extraordinary circumstances. The bishop who ordained him was Bishop Ayu in 1965. And the ordination took place providentially in the chapel of St. Teresa's College in Nsukka, where he started the journey. And the ordination took place at 4 p.m. in the evening. Because the bishop had a wedding in the morning. And it was communicated to him just 3 days before ordination. That time he recalls that because he was afraid to need to engage being a priest from his home, he was afraid to go home because he would have been adopted and each day he could be teaching him. He ran and being in the house of the brethren here at the Cambridge University. And from there he came for the ordination. I want to take back my name, Chief Kakuma Pemba. Help by the man of the Chief Kakuma Pemba, Mr. Kakuma. I said, no, I'm not a mess. Hey, Chief Kakuma, not a few years ago, I got a lot of fun at the library. But if they came out of the past, I saw nobody was blessed. After the ordination, he jumped into the back of a waiting room and went back in that back. The incredible was brought him halfway and he traveled the rest of the road back in his home. And of course, all through his years in the seminary, it was a case of determination. And even after his ordination, his assignments and the way he took his assignments were all meant to indicate what we had in the second reading today. I complete in my life what is lacking in the suffering of Christ. Father, I don't know what we have done Because if you begin to point out his nakedness, some of them may have a problem. Some of them may have a problem. They are in the and I know what we have been as a priest. And what he has been that has been in prison. And the question is about being, not about doing. That is the message that is a niche for us. 50 years after his first mass. I told you Valencia was present in many ways. On that memorable 4th of July 2013, when I was ordained bishop at his hall, I was sitting there from where I was sitting, here at the center. Father Eze, the oldest priest in this diocese, was the first to come up and pay his allegiance to the new bishop. That is not what I will never ever forget as long as I live. As he was led up the steps, slowly and gradually, my father said, "No, who is the voice?" Father is the baby in front of me. And the man who took my steps wanted me to salute his new bishop. And that was not all. He had tears in his eyes. And much as I tried, I could not hold back my tears for the rest of the sermon. And even now, as I tell you the story, I'm fighting to hold back my tears. Because I asked myself, why is this man crying? What does this event mean for me in his life as a priest? And that is the challenge. Thank you. And because they met in Rome, and suddenly there was such a friend to him, that the captain said, if I had not been living in the country of Jubilee, I would have done everything to be in Nsukka on Friday. And that Bishop Uwu, his classmate, was almost on his way to this place yesterday when he called to say he couldn't make it for that charity. This is the type of motivation, this is the type of inspiration that we are grateful to God for, that we can get from our older priests. Those who believe and still believe that it is not about what you do as a priest, it is about who you are and who are you. We are only an instrument of God's love, of God's blessings. You are only a blessing, a non-human being, without any special biological changes, in spite of all the training in the center, a non-human being who has allowed himself to be a child of God's grace. People like Father Eze are incredibly important in our time. Because we have a picture in the Catholic priesthood today of what I call protagonism. And not just simple protagonism, but a type of apologetical, aggressive protagonism, obsessive protagonism. Many of us priests want to be doing so many things their own way that they even set aside the principles laid down by the church in order to draw attention to themselves, up to the point that even during the celebration of the Eucharist, instead of following the words as they write, some of us are tempted to throw in our jargons and gestures here and there to draw our attention to ourselves, as if it were about us and not about him. An example is what will happen the next weekend in our parishes. You know, you guys, it will be Pentecost weekend. The program of Pentecost weekend is left to the fancies and better imaginations of many priests. And of course, his willing collaborators and the charismatic leader for the Pentecost weekend. Why? One, directs the attention to the mystery of the cross and the resurrection. The other one, under the freedom. We need older priests to remind us of what the church is about. And I'm not quite sure what the reason. It was a very difficult period for them. But more importantly for us locally, the gospel reading says that Jesus can actually express the mind of the European minister of God. He said, priests, bishops, you should